mathematics in science and in my personal life. Application of math. The fair lane assignment in BMX bicycle race. I need lanes in BMX that is fair. Minimize the unfairness. Professor uses math to uncover flaw in BMX races. See math to construct a psychedelic video for hour in 70 Chevelle. This is the mathematical model of fluid flow. This is Navier-Stokes flow.
One of these kind of virus movies, I think the plot line is a female scientist engineered a virus for gene therapy to cure cancer. And I'm like, that was me!
So V is called a vertex set. Basically, circle E are called edges. And it basically connects circles. I fired a gene that I know, and it somewhat lights up some gene that I didn't really know the function of, I have some inkling of what that gene could do.
Now, remediation is basically the fancy term to say that we want to clean up these contaminated sites. We are tracking very small amount of stuff over a long period of time. Here's another example, so we have to maximize all production.
Chemistry, patent statistics, guidance to answer are, will be able to say something about the outcomes of our process and the uncertainty of those outcomes. And with those outcomes, we can make our decisions. Think about where the data came from and what population it's representing. The basic examples, do we spend the money to drill for oil to drill?
Crisis in higher education. What are we underrepresented minorities doing in education? We drop out of high school, blacks go a little bit of college, Asians go to college a bit more. For good reason, the nation uses representation in the areas of mathematics, computer science, and electrical engineering as indicators of the health of STEM representation. Underrepresented minorities tend not to train in the areas where they're educated. Why worry about underrepresentation? Our representation in the population is exploding. Our representation in STEM discipline is not improving. It's an unhealthy national situation.
But clicks people like me are making. So there's so much information. We exploit the massive amounts of data we gather to help answer questions that matter to us. So typically we're interested in some complicated system drawn in black over there. It could be you or me.
What we end up doing is we actually extract features from these images or aspects of these images. And we
most movies are boring. Most images are boring. Most sound files are boring because they all sound like static and look like static and have no structure. If we know the structure of the images we want, we can store them in less data. Images, photos of people and cats. We're fine with losing some of the quality of the images. This is a case where we will not tolerate errors in the image. After all, if we're going to spend $700 million...
That requires something called public key cryptography. This is where the math is going to start, and I need you to engage those brains. We're going to need something called modular arithmetic. It's a very simple concept. So it's a theorem from 1736 of the Swiss mathematician Euler. In 1778, they figured out that Euler's theorem can be used to make this idea completely precise.
I'm trying to share many things with you. Okay, awareness of... We set the national record racing band at 57. We build a drag. This study will lead us to the fundamental theorem of drag racing. Accelerating for small time, and the jet car is accelerating for large time. That's the difference. If you want to win a short race, then accelerate as much as you can at the start and be totally undone by the end of the race and just hang on.
Your birth, nanoseconds before midnight. A fleeting glimpse, nothing, in the rounding errors, if you will, formation of that is how a scalar evolves over time. The relative shot of Earth compared to the other components of our solar system. On anything that we're looking at on Earth, it's really challenging to differentiate in this scale and variance. And this guy is Mars.
That during the production of this oil, there are certain components in that oil that produce these deposits. So you can make an analogy to what cholesterol makes in our bloodstream. So this heavy material, easy mathematical relation that can relate the properties of interest.
At the nanoscale, when we get to nanometer size,
the size of the cerebellar particle is the color that you get.
That spaghetti has no strength.
But if you take a lot of spaghetti, in this case, then they are strong. But the problem is, how do you get to this from disorder to order. So you have carbon nanotubes, when they come out of the reactor, they look like this. You see that black powder?
The study of atoms or even electrons as they move around in crystals to these giant crystals. You say, well, how do I know they're giant? Well, there's a person there just to put it. Crystallography works by shining X-rays on a crystal. You measure a diffraction pattern. You use math and physics to work backwards to the arrangement of the atoms that gave rise to that diffraction pattern. So you didn't hear enough credit. Figured out the atomic structure of DNA by understanding